Assalamu alaikum. Today's lesson is from the third year, from a third year topic that is the electromagnetic fields. And the title we are going to talk about is Coulomb's law and field intensity. Okay, then Coulomb's law states that the force F. We're gonna be talking about the force first. So the force F between any two point charges Q1 and Q2 is first is along the line joining them. That is the force exerted by Q1 on Q2 is acting along the line joining those two charges Q1 and Q2. And the force exerted by Q2 on Q1 is along the same line, only in the opposite direction. Secondly, this force is directly proportional to the product of those two charges, Q1 and Q2. Thirdly, the force is inversely proportional to the square of the distance R. So if the distance between those two charges is R, then the force is proportional to the square of R. In compact form, so F12 equals Q1 times Q2 over 4 pi E R squared in a direction of a unit vector named AR12. Now E is equal E naught for free space, and E naught is 8.854 times 10 to the minus 12, which is approximately 10 to the minus 9 over 36 pi farad per meter. And now we're going to turn to the to defining the unit vector AR12. Now if we look the figure ahead of us, we see two point charges Q1 and Q2 located in free space at distances R1 and R2 from the origin. Now the force exerted by Q1 on Q2 is F12. So that is the force F12 exerted by charge Q1 on charge Q2. It is along the line joining Q1 and Q2. That is the line defined by the vector R12. Of course, it is opposite in direction to the other force exerted by Q2 on Q1, F21. So R12 is a vector directed from charge Q1 to charge Q2. Which equals to R2 minus R1. And that's the vector. The distance of this vector is the modulus of R12. Now this way, to determine the unit vector AR12, we should divide the vector R12 by its distance. So it's equal to R12 over R. And this way, the force F12 is equal to Q1 Q2 times R2 minus R1 over 4 pi E R2 minus R1 modulus, and is tripled or cubed. Of course, as we have mentioned earlier, F21 is equal to minus F12 because they are acting on the same line. Okay, the electric field intensity or electric field strength, E, is the force per unit charge when placed in the electric field. That is, if we place a charge in the electric field of another charge. So we see that E is exerting, or the first charge is exerting a force on the second charge, or a strength on the second charge, named the electric field strength, and it is equal to the force per unit charge. So E is equal to F divided by Q. So E is equal to Q over 4 pi E R squared in the direction of AR, or it is equal to Q times R minus R dash. These are the two radii of the first charge and the location in which we are going to determine the electric field intensity at a distance R dash. So it's a Q times R minus R dash, that's a vector, over 4 pi E R minus R dash modulus cubed. Now let's take an example. Now supposing we have two charges located at a 3, 2, minus 1, or 1 millicoulomb, and a minus 2 millicoulomb located at minus 1, minus 1, 4 respectively. And if we need to calculate the force, the electric force, on a third positive charge, 10 nanocoulomb charge, that is located at 0, 3, 1, and the electric field intensity at that point, at the point of the third charge. Of course, to determine the force on the third charge, we need to calculate the force of the first charge and the second charge, because they are both exerting force on the third charge. So F is equal to the summation QQK over 4 pi ER squared in the direction of AR, K equals 1 to 2. So that is Q1 Q3 over 4 pi ER 1 2 in the direction of AR 1 2 plus Q2 Q3 over 4 pi ER 2 3 in the direction of AR 2 3. Of course, we have the third charge, and 4 pi E is common, so we should take them out of the parentheses. And we have the first charge, which is 1 millicoulomb, that is 10 to the minus 3 times AR. Now AR is the location of the third charge minus the location of the first charge over its distance squared, multiplied by its distance again, so it's cubed, minus, to account for the negative charge of negativity of the second charge, and the location of the third charge minus the location of the second charge, minus 1, minus 4. And that's how we get the force, which equals at last to minus 6.507 in the direction of AX, minus 3.817 in the direction of AY, plus 7.506 in the direction of AZ, millinewton. And to find the electric field strength, we need to divide the force we have just got by the magnitude of the third charge. So that is the force we have just gotten, because it's in millinewton times 10 to the minus 3 divided by the magnitude of the third charge, which was 10 nanocoulombs. And this way we get the electric field intensity at the point of the, or at the location of the third charge. Of course, we don't have in real life just point charges. We have electric fields due to continuous charge distributions. So we have a line charge, a surface charge, and a volume charge. And to determine the charge from a line charge, we need to integrate the line charge with respect to differential length. And for the surface charge, we need to double integrate the rho s, that is the surface charge, with the differential surface to get the charge. And it's the same for the volume charge. We need to integrate it three times with respect to differential volume. And this way we have E, the electric field intensity, for the line charge is equal to an integration of rho L dL. That is a Q. So we have the same rule again, Q over 4 pi E naught R squared in the direction of AR. And for the surface charges, it's a double integration of rho S to dS over 4, because that is the Q again, over 4 pi E naught R squared in the direction of AR. And it's the same for the last distribution, which is a volume charge. Thanks a lot.